Hello again, everyone, and welcome back to my Linux Crash Course series. In this video, what we're going to do is take a look at a very important command, the IP command. You definitely have to learn this command. In fact, it's mandatory, but thankfully it's easy to learn and you don't have to memorize all of the options. You just have to know the basic usage. And in this video, I'm going to teach you everything you need to know to get started with this command. Anyway, the IP command is part of the IP Route 2 package. It's a full suite of utilities and not just a command. The IP command gives you the ability to do things like add a route, set up a static IP address, and a lot more. The IP command replaces two other commands that we used to use on Linux. Now, these two commands are still available, but they're being deprecated. I'm referring to the ifconfig command and the route command. The IP command takes the responsibility of both of those commands because it does everything that those two commands used to do for us, and then some. But before we get to that, I just wanted to let you guys know that I have two brand new courses available over on Udemy. First, if you're in the process of learning Linux for the very first time, you should definitely check out my Linux Essentials course. Not only will this course teach you everything you need to know to get started and learn the basics of Linux, it's also going to help you get certified and earn your Linux Essentials credential through LPI. And the Linux Professional Institute is the world's largest Linux and open source focused vendor-neutral certification body. So by earning certifications through LPI, your credentials will be recognized around the world. But even if you don't have any interest in getting certified, this course is still a great fit for those of you that are getting started with Linux because it'll teach you all the basics. Also, I recently released an Ansible course as well, which will teach you everything you need to know to get up and running with Ansible. Ansible is one of, if not the most popular configuration and automation platforms in the Linux ecosystem, so it's definitely something that you need to learn. Ansible is a powerful and easy-to-learn platform that'll enable you to automate even the most complicated Linux administration tasks. And just like with my Linux course, each lesson will break down even the most complicated components and concepts into easy-to-understand lessons, and by the end of the course, you'll learn everything that you need to know to use Ansible as part of your daily toolset. And thank you guys so much for checking out my courses and supporting this channel. I really appreciate it. Now, let's dive into the IP command. And we're going to start with a very simple example. What I'm going to do is type IP, and then ADDR, and then show, just like that. Now, of all the commands that I'm going to show you in this video, this one here is the most likely for you to already know. This is a very common variation of the IP command. Whenever we want to view information regarding network interfaces on our system, this is the go-to command for that purpose. And as you can see, it gives me all kinds of information regarding my interfaces. Interface number one is going to be my loopback adapter, and then interface number two is going to be for Wi-Fi. We can see here that I have an IP address of 172.16.250.105. I'm on a /24 network. We can see the broadcast address, 172.16.250.255. We have the MAC address for the network interface and other information as well. Another really cool trick is instead of typing this entire command, you can actually abbreviate it down to IP space A. It's the same command, it's just abbreviated, so the output will look identical. And this is the way that I normally do it, IP space A. You can abbreviate it and save some keystrokes. Now what I'm going to do is bring back the original example, and I'm going to add to it. In the output earlier, we saw that my interface name for my Wi-Fi adapter was WLO1. So what I could do is add dev, short for device, and then the name of the interface. Now notice that I did not abbreviate the command this time. And that's because if I did, it wouldn't work. But anyway, I'll press enter so you can see what this command does. And you'll notice that information regarding the loopback adapter is not present. And that's because I specifically wanted to see device WLO1, so the output was limited to just that. So far, the commands that we've seen make no changes to the system whatsoever. IP space A, short for IP ADDR show, that gives us information about our network interfaces as you've just seen. Now going further, I want to let you know though that we will be executing commands that will make changes to the system, especially with network connections. So I don't want you guys to practice on a production server, and I'm not going to be responsible if you break anything. It's perfectly acceptable to just watch me and take notes, And if you want to err on the side of caution, that's totally fine. But if you have a test system, then have fun. You can execute all of the commands that you want. I just wanted to let you know that we will be disconnecting the network, which could result in you getting locked out of your server if you've connected to it via SSH, for example. Anyway, let's see some more examples. What I'll do is bring up the interface list again. So this output should look very familiar. But what I want to do right now is show you that you can actually down an interface. And I'll show you that right now. So what I'll do is type sudo, because I will be making changes this time. And again, you could just write notes if you don't want to execute this on your system. But what we'll do is type IP. We want to work with a link, a connection, basically. Want to set something. We want to set something on a particular interface. So I typed in mine. And then what I'll do is type down. And if I type IP space A again, notice that WLO1, my wireless interface, is now down, which also means I'm not going to be able to get to my website either. As you can see, there's no way to get to my website. Now what we're going to do is reverse the process and bring the interface back up again. Now if I check the IP address again, we can now see that the wireless interface is now up. We see the word up right there, and that should mean that we're back up and running. So let's see. Check it out. Now I'm able to ping the website for the channel. Now what I'm going to do is show you how to add an IP address to an interface. So if we look at it again, I have an IP address of 172.16.250.105. So what I'll do is type sudo and then IP, then ADDR. I want to add an IP address. I'm just going to make up a random IP address of 192.168.0.123. So I guess that should be fine. I'll just use the typical /24 for the network. Then we type dev, and then the interface name. Sorry to interrupt my own video, but I just wanted to let you know that I appreciate each and every single one of you, and I love creating Linux-related content for you guys. But unfortunately, producing high-quality Linux content like this isn't cheap. But if you want to help me make even more content for you guys, then consider supporting Learn Linux TV. And a great way to do that is to check out the official shop for Learn Linux TV, which was just recently updated. Inside the shop, you'll find distro-themed shirts, bags, drinkware, and more. And there's some other surprises there as well. For example, I've just introduced a mouse pad that doubles as a Tmux cheat sheet. How cool is that? So check out the shop at merch.learnlinux.tv, or you could check out the merch shelf right here on YouTube. You could get yourself something really cool and support Linux learning at the same time, so it's a win-win. Anyway, thank you guys so much for your support. I really appreciate it. Now, let's get back to the video. Now, we might just want one IP address, so what I'll do is just remove the first one. And the command will be similar to the first one, but we're going to use del instead of add. We're going to type the IP address that we want removed. And then the device that we want to remove it from, which in my case is the wireless interface, so let's see what happens. Well, it didn't complain at least. And here we can see that I have only the new IP address that I've added to the interface. Now on my end, that's an invalid IP address, so I'm not going to be able to ping anything at this point. I just used that IP address as a made-up example. It doesn't actually belong to anything. You'll notice that it's not going to respond. What I'll do is just bring the interface down and then back up again to restore my network connection. That should restore the IP address automatically. Let's bring it back up. I'll give it a few seconds and then we'll check it. And as we can see right here, the IP address was replaced with the correct one that came in via DHCP as soon as I upped the interface. And now I'm able to reach the internet again. Now let's take a look at routing. We could print the routing table for our system with the IP command with this variation right here, IP route show. Now, I only have one route on my end. It's the only network that my computer is connected to in the first place. But we can see some really good information here. For example, we see that 172.16.250.1, that's the default gateway. So basically, anytime I want to access something via the network here, it's going to go out via the default gateway, which in this case is going to be my pfSense firewall, and then go out to the internet from there. If I was to remove this route, then obviously my computer wouldn't know how to get to anything. We have to have a route. The network stack basically has to know how to get out of your network to other networks, and basically we just need to point it to its default gateway, which will take care of the rest. We could also see that my network address is 172.16.250.0/24. So that's my network address, and then we have 172.16.250.105. That's the IP address of this local machine. So if we put that together, if my machine wants to go out to the network, it's part of 172.16.250.0/24. That's the network that it's on. If it wants to get to a different network, it's going to have to do so via the default gateway of 172.16.250.1, and that's how it's going to route. Now, this command right here is purely informational. It just prints the routing table, and that's just about it. That's why we didn't need to use sudo for this command, because we're not making changes. We just want to see the routing table, and that's all. Now, in my case, I only have one route, and that makes sense. I have just one interface. It's a laptop anyway. If it was a server, especially a cloud server, I might have more routes here. But anyway, it's a really good idea to check your routing table anytime you're having a problem getting to another network. For example, let's say you're trying to use SSH to log into a computer, and for whatever reason, that's not working, but other computers are able to SSH into that same machine. Perhaps yours is the only one that doesn't get to that machine. In that case, your machine might have a missing route. If there's no routing entry here for the network that you want to access, then you can't access it. Now, most of the time, it's not up to you to set routes on your system. That's going to be set by the router, the firewall. Perhaps BGP will have something to do with it. If the network administrator is someone other than you, then that's their responsibility. But every now and then, especially with cloud servers, you might need to check the routing table and add a route to another network if necessary. Now, let's see an example of adding a route to a routing table. So what I'll do is type sudo, because this time I will be making changes. Of course, we are working with the IP command. And this time, we are working with the routing table. We want to add a route this time. And what I'm going to do is just add a network address for another network. This isn't actually going to work, but it's just an example of the syntax, so we'll just pretend like this is valid. So we're going to type the network address for the network that we want to add a route for. Next, we need to identify the default gateway. We do so by typing via, and then the IP address to the default gateway for this network. So I'll type that in, and then I'll type the default gateway. Any routes we need to attach to a specific interface. I'll type mine in right here, and let's see what happens. Well, it didn't complain, at least. And here we see the other network. So what I'm going to do right now, especially since that's an invalid network, I'm going to remove it. So all we have to do is change add to DEL for delete. And as you can see, the routing entry has been deleted. Now there's a bunch of different examples I could give you guys when it comes to the IP command, but in this video, I'm mainly sticking to the basics, especially since it's virtually impossible to cover the entirety of the IP command in one video. But what I am going to do is give you a very useful example, and it's this one right here. Now, earlier in the video, we were working with IP addresses, and for that, we typed IP80DR. When we started working with routes, we typed IP route. And now, this time, we have link instead, and that refers to the link layer. So what I want to do is print statistics regarding the link layer regarding interface WL01. So what I'll do is press Enter, and you can see some very useful statistics here. Now, this could be very useful if you wanted to test for dropped packets, or you had some sort of a networking issue you were troubleshooting. and you wanted to find out about errors or dropped packets, well, this is how you do it. Also, what we could do to make this even better is combine it with the watch command, and then we put the command in double quotes just like this. Now, every 2 seconds, the output will update. With the watch command, which I covered in another video, it's going to run the command that we give it as an argument every 2 seconds. So definitely check out that video if you want to learn more about the watch command. But right here, I combined the watch command with the ip-s link show and then interface name command. As you can see, that's the command we could use to view statistics. I could basically make a change to the IP stack in one terminal window, and then in another, I can watch exactly what's going on with the statistics. And there you go. In this video, we took a look at the basics of the IP command. I hope you enjoyed it. The IP command, like I mentioned earlier, is really important to learn, but thankfully, you just have to learn the basics. You could check the man page, you could write notes for the variations of the command that you use most often, but it's definitely something to know. Now, what did you think of this video? Let me know in the comments down below what you thought of this video. I really appreciate that, and I have a ton of content coming that I can't wait for you guys to see, so definitely subscribe to Learn Linux TV for the latest in Linux, and I'll see you in the next video.